Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Friday, January 28th, 2011. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback. Please leave a comment when you're done watching this video. Even if you just say hi or thanks, I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is an hourly chart without indicators for the Euro-USD currency pair as that chart looked on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. Now I've got this chart zoomed out to show the price action from Wednesday's Asian session open to today's Asian session open. One recent key level for this pair that I talked about in yesterday's New York session video review has been the 1.3680 level. That level seemed to define yesterday's New York session low right there. Now another level, or maybe I should say area, worthy of mention based on price action over the past couple of trading days, that's the 1.3710 to 1.3720 area, which I've represented by a horizontal black line on this chart at 1.3715. Wednesday's London and New York session highs were generally defined by that area, and looking at Thursday's price action, the euro seemed to find support in that area during much of the yesterday's European afternoon. Okay, now let's look at a 15-minute chart showing today's price action. This is how the 15-minute chart looked at the open of the New York session, 8 a.m. New York time. Now, as I mentioned in my live coaching session during the first half of the New York morning, the same area between 1.3710 and 1.3720 also seemed to influence price action during today's Asian and London sessions. I've highlighted in blue where price seemed to react to that area. Now, folks, it is not unusual for a level on a major currency pair to flip from support during one session to resistance during the next session, or vice versa. In that context, one prospective trade plan for Euro bears, which we discussed before the end of my coaching session, was to let this pair drop down to that 1.3680 area, which has been so important this week, then bounce back up and rise to retest that 1.3715 area, and then short it there or near there. Now, the one news event which could affect sentiment on the U.S. dollar and maybe prompt you to reconsider such a plan is the release of the first estimate of U.S. GDP for the previous quarter, that is for a fourth quarter of last year. Let's switch now to a 3-minute chart and move forward in time by 90 minutes to see how the euro reacted to that U.S. report. Here's the 3-minute chart as it looked at the U.S. equity market open, 9:30 a.m. New York time. The big red candle that I just highlighted with the blue marker, that represents the reaction during the first 3 minutes after the release of the U.S. GDP report. Now, although the headline number was lower than expected, suggesting possibly some pressure on the dollar, over the next 30 minutes we reviewed some of the details in that GDP report, and many of those details were actually positives, including a 7.1% rise in what's called real final sales, the highest quarter of a quarter rise since 1984. The question in my mind as my session came to a close was this: will the U.S. dollar firm up as the market sees the positives behind the slightly lower than expected headline number? Consider this. During the first minute after the release of that GDP report, the euro spent less than one minute above the 1.3720 level, which is right here. So again, this part of the 3-minute candle, less than 1 minute of time immediately after the news release was spent above that level. So if you ignore that roughly 30 seconds the euro spent above 1.3720, this pair has mostly been below that black line at 1.3715 since the New York session opened 90 minutes ago. By the way, the session opened represented by the vertical bright red line on the left-hand side of this chart. Also, this pair has not only dropped gradually since the news, but it even bounced just 3 pips above the 1.3680 level I mentioned earlier. Look on the lower right-hand side of the chart. There's the bounce less than 3 minutes ago at just above 1.3680. So, for the Euro bears, the plan we discussed earlier to short this pair somewhere in the 1.3710 to 20 area might still pan out. Roughly 20 minutes later, If you were a bear, you got your chance. If you took the shot, you probably went short at or just below 1.3715 during the red candle that I've just identified with the blue arrow. Your stop loss could be positioned 50 pips above your entry for catastrophic protection purposes. And as for exit strategies, I've mentioned several ways to define exit strategies in past videos. Now, since the predominant trend over the past 3 weeks has been up on this pair, you could call this short a counter-trend trade. In that context, taking a loss sooner than later isn't a bad idea. Looking at the upper left-hand portion of this chart, up in here, I see a swing high. I'm talking about this area here. I see a swing high at about 1.3734 in about 2 hours ago. The next logical resistance level above that is the weekly R1 pivot point near 1.3750. And that's just way too much room to give an intraday counter trend spot trade. So a euro move above 1.3730 could be your reason to close the short trade. Less than 15 minutes later, you were sitting on a short trade profit of about 20 pips, somewhere in there. At that point, it was reasonable to move your stop loss to break even. Now, was it about that time that news about renewed rioting in Egypt hit multiple, I stress multiple, financial markets? Several traditional safe havens caught a strong bid all at once. Gold spiked higher, U.S. treasuries rallied, the dollar rose, the Japanese yen rose, the Swiss franc even rose. Also, equities sold off sharply, and the real clue, to me at least, the real clue that events in Egypt were at least a catalyst for those moves was the rise in oil. Oil gained more than 4% when the day was in the books. Okay, let's switch back to the 15-minute chart and fast forward to the London close. Looking on the lower right-hand portion of this chart, I saw two profit target choices for this short trade. One here at the daily M1 pivot point, which today was at 1.3622, and the other target at 1.36, the psychological level, which the euro reached less than 2 minutes before London close on the red candle that I'm circling now. London close represented by the vertical red line on this chart. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Friday, January 28th.